you've no purpose here, lad.
Looking for trouble.
Saddlers of the First Water, Putney's on Mill Road, a name and reputation. Boston Gazette humbly proposes.
Thank you. Welcome back.
You left me in Boston.
The training we've done here is all well and good, but experience is a better teacher by far.
What of my father?
Into the wind, I'm afraid.
We have to find him.
And we will, after the house has been repaired.
But he's out there plotting who knows what.
And what would you do when you found him? If you found him? You're a boy with a few months of training. He's a man, full-grown, who spent decades honing his skills. If you're going to stand a chance against the Templars, you're going to need these. Go on before I change my mind.
Sir, please, help! He's going to die!
Who?
There's no time! Please come! Down there! He's just...
What this knobend is trying to say is he's forever in your debt, sir.
Who are you calling? A knobend? You!
Because you are one.
What were you doing on those logs?
One of the dangers of lumbering. We've got the camp set up a few rods off of here as we're cutting timber. We're hoping to open a mill in the area.
There's a good place not far from the manor on the hill where I'm staying.
I like you already. We'll have a look.
I'll miss the peace and quiet, but we can certainly use the wood.
The manor needs a lot of work.
That and other things. Meet me at the small shack by the shoreline when you have time. There's something else you need to see.
What is it?
An asset.
in God's name, Annie!
Thank you. Thank you.
Are you all right?
I think so. Didn't do much to me aside from a good scare, blackguards.
What did they want with you?
My purse, which was meager, and they decided to punish me for their trouble. Silly, really. My tools and equipment were worth a king's share to the right man. In any case, I had best get on my way. It's a long walk to the nearest inn. I thank you again for your kindness.
Have you no home?
Oh, well, I was a proud resident of Boston until recently, but I'm not a supporter of His Majesty, and, well, I was forced out of my wood shop and home by loyalists.
There are plenty around here who could use the services of a skilled craftsman if you were looking for somewhere to settle.
Is that right? I may look into that. Morning.
But I have them! Captain Kidd had a secret, to be sure. He gave me a ship and a crew. And he knew what it was he held so dear. I met him once. He was 7 feet tall. He was an inch. I saw him. He's like tree trunks with a smithy's arms.
Come dear, a man to quit the... Go away!
Said, go away, boy! Do not speak the king's English? Oh, I didn't see you there, old man. I'd have set my home in order if I'd known you'd be calling.
The boy's name is Connor. He's here to restore the property.
Restore? Restore? Pardon my manners. She's still the fastest in the Atlantic. Sure, she needs some attention. Minor things, mostly, but with a little affection, she'll fly again.
Who is she?
Who is she? Why, the Aquila boy, the ghost of the North Seas.
The boat.
A boat? She's a ship, boy, and make no mistake about it. I thought you brought him here to restore order. I reckon he's the greenest thing on the frontier.
Connor, meet me back at the manor when you've finished here.
You said it requires repairs. You able?
She does need work. A ship is a she, boy. And yes, I can refit her, but I'm lacking in the proper supplies. Some quality timber would help me get started.
I can see to that. How long before it... she... is able to sail again?
Just get me the lumber, boy. I'll raise a crew.